My name is Paul Rusesabagina. I am the house manager of the most luxurious hotel in the capital of Rwanda.
Rare it is where we have a guest in studio, and I actually am in awe and a bit intimidated, but that is the case. Joining me right now in our Beacon Hill studio is the man who Don Cheadle portrays in Hotel Rwanda. His name is Paul Rusesabagina. Did I get that right?
Very right.
Thank you. I like that. That's good.
Paul Rusesabagina. The name might be unfamiliar, so might his story, but this smiling man in the spotlight has been to hell and back.
It's unbelievable. You can never imagine from hell to Hollywood.
This unassuming man risked his life to save more than 1,200 people from the genocide that tore apart the Central African nation of Rwanda 11 years ago.
Often you were referred to as the Rwandan Schindler, from Schindler's List, of course, the man who got people away from the Nazis. You saved almost 1,300 lives.
I don't believe that I saved lives. I helped people who were in need.
With the movie spotlight have come awards and accolades, this one from LA's Museum of Tolerance.
You are a living symbol of hope to us all, and God bless you.
Now, you're in an international speaking tour. You're with the... What your message is and what you want people to learn from your experiences?
My message across the country and internationally is to let to wake up the whole international community and let the people know that Africa is also there. A human life in Africa has got the same value as it is here.
In 1994, he was serving as the manager of the most elegant hotel in Kigali, the capital city of Rwanda, when Rwanda's president was assassinated. Ethnic violence broke out across the country. And over the course of the next 100 days, over 800 million people were killed. Rwanda was deserted by the international peacekeepers. But as the country of Rwanda descended into madness, one man was able to protect not only the family he loved, but he ended up finding the courage to save over 1,200 people.
The Rwandan genocide was very easy to stop, but no one was willing to. Most of the army people were not willing to kill innocent civilians. They were rather defending civilians. But were discouraged very much to see the way that the international community left us, abandoned us, giving a green light to the militia who became more powerful. Many people will tell me that you have identified problems. Where are the solutions? What can we do? I can assure you, you can do a lot and much more. Ladies and gentlemen, what Africans need is not only food. We do not only need salt and sugar, but we need a long-term solution. A long-term solution is to help Africans to get rid of all of those dictators. And I know very well, and each and every one of you knows that behind each and every dictatorship, there is always a Western superpower. What we need from you is what you did about 20 years ago and less for South Africa. The whole world should get up and help us solving our problems. And solving problems is to bring people back to the negotiating table. Let them talk and come to a compromise. Come to peace. People need peace. And as long as those Western superpowers are still maneuvering, peace will come. Ladies and gentlemen, tonight, I can assure you that if you want You can make it. If you want, you can make a difference. If you want, you can help. Not only by giving food, but also by solving problems. Thank you very much. Thank you.
Thank you.